to Brands Hatch for the season finale of the 2016 BRSCC Quaife Fiesta Championship. Well, as the tension mounts, I'm here in assembly as the cars wait to go out for race one in Class C. Sam Priest is on second on the grid, and with the championship at stake, his nearest contenders are just the row behind. Sam, I'm going to ask if I can have your thoughts going into the race, because there's a lot to play for out there today.
Yeah, I've got the championship at stake. I've just got to get out there and do my thing, try and bring home a good position, and I know what I've got to do, and I've just got to drive the best I can.
Circuit is known for potential carnage on the first lap at least. How are you going to try and stay out of trouble?
Yeah, fortunately I had a good qualifying which put me at the front end of the grid on second. I've got that for both races, and normally the carnage seems to happen mid-pack, so fingers crossed that's where it'll happen and not at the front.
Indeed, fingers crossed. I'll hopefully be talking to you later.
Thank you.
And with that, it's back to the commentary box.
Thanks, Rachel. Pole position then to Simon Horobin from Sam Priest, then Nathan Edwards and JJ Ross. Ryan Falconbridge and Aaron Thompson next from Miles Baker and Nick Bowers, Alfonso Skritzka and Lee Dendy-Sadler next up from Jamie Going and Josh Watkins, then Tim Glover and Dan Turner, Richard Dawson and Jay Daniels, followed by David Pugh and Dana Freeman, Jason Powell and Kevin Gooding completing the grid. Good to see Dana making her Class C debut. Great start though by Simon Horobin, and slotting into second is Sam Priest. Here is the view from Nathan Edwards in third place on the grid. JJ Ross gets the jump on him on the outside line into Paddock. Aaron Thompson's in the mix as well. Good move by Thompson around the outside at Paddock. And Thompson, of course, challenging for a major position in the table in his first year of senior racing. Goes very wide, and Edwards is going to look down the inside line, but Thompson's got the racing line going down into Graham Hill Bend. Here is the view from Edwards in fourth place at the moment. Fifth place, beg your pardon. Thompson goes wide. I think allowable on the first lap, but of course here at Brands Hatch, the officials will be keeping a close eye over the course of the race. So out front, Simon Horobin from Sam Priest. JJ Ross is in third position. JJ last year's champion, and of course Aaron Thompson last year's junior champion. So the that's really indicative of the fact that drivers stay with the Ford Championship. Some drivers of course move on. We've spoken many times over recent years about drivers going into Clio Cup, and there's a definitely a ladder from this championship up into Clio's if you can maybe get the budget together to do that, but drivers do stay in. Great move by Thompson up into third place. JJ Ross is down into fourth, and Nathan Edwards has got a change of view, so he's looking at the yellow fella out front as they come down into Graham Hill Bend. Well, as you can see, it was just first lap eagerness I think that saw Aaron going wide on the previous lap. This time everybody is very much on the tarmac keeping it that way, and Thompson is taking the battle to the championship leader here. Alfonso Skritzka is away back. He's the main championship challenger to the car with the blue roof, Sam Priest. Sam running in second place. 9 points in the championship. Sam Priest is ahead of the closest challenger, Alfonso Skritzka. Alfonso punished by the drop scores rule. He has finished every single race this year and drops an incredible 40 points. Nathan Edwards looks up the inside line on JJ Ross as they go around Druids. Edwards trying the hard way here. Ross knows that he's got the inside line coming down into Graham Hill Bend. And now, here is the view from Nathan Edwards again going along the straight. Inside line, is he going to be able to just nip through here at Surtees? He's thinking about this, but that converts to the outside as they go into McLaren and then into Clearways. And Ross knows that, and coming up in the mix as well is Alfonso Skritzka, who's had a superb start. Skritzka started down in ninth place and has joined this battle superbly. So Skritzka not letting the championship nerves get to him. Here's the view from Nathan Edwards once again into Paddock Hill Bend. Just look at the drop here. Skritzka goes past Edwards. Good move by Alfonso. He's been so consistent over the course of this season. And, of course, fast as well. Skritzka's been on the podium. Hasn't taken a win yet. But it's all about consistency. Finishing every race. As I say, he does get punished on the drop scores. So too does Sam Priest. Sam has to drop 23 points in the championship. He had one non-finish Sam Preece, which was round six of the championship at Rockingham. But the Aldershot racer, Skritzker, now is going to try and close down on JJ Ross. JJ's only done a partial season, so he's not a championship contender. It's the two specialised motorsport cars still out front as we go in car with Josh Watkins. Nice to see him back in the mix. And Josh qualifying in 12th place just behind Jamie Going and Lee Dendy Sadler. So here they come, up Halewood Hill in towards Druids. Fine field of cars here with drivers moving up into the formula. Dan Turner there in the Specialised Motorsport 17. Good to see Dan in the formula now as well with the number 11 car, Lee Dendy Sadler, who we saw running strongly, strongest meeting of the season last time out for him, which was at Anglesey. And Lee, you might remember, had four non-finishes in the first six races of the season and then took a break and rejoined us and is really getting back into the groove. And following him is Tim Glover, Yateley based driver, who's been with us all season, only had one non-classification, which was round three. So another driver who's been a consistent finisher in this championship, which runs right up and down the country. Snetterton, Silverstone, Rockingham, second outing at Snetterton in June, Castle Coombe, second outing at Silverstone in August, then Anglesey. And here we are at the Formula Ford Festival at Brands Hatch, one of the biggest meetings, biggest club meetings in the UK of the year, and a chance to celebrate all things Ford. So Lee Dendy Sadler trying to close in on that 17 car of Dan Turner. Meanwhile, we go back to the battle for third place. Aaron Thompson is still there at the moment, the white and red car, followed by JJ Ross. But coming through on the inside line is Alfonso Skritzker. Read that very well indeed. That's a classic Brands Hatch pass. And meanwhile, Nathan Edwards will want to try and use that momentum to follow through. But JJ Ross might come across and shut the door. There's a little bit of room there at the moment. JJ also, of course, thinking about the line into Paddock Hill Bend. JJ goes wide, Edwards goes through on the inside line. Great piece of saloon car racing by the pair of them. Clean and fair, exactly what we like to see. And down behind them, we've got Jamie Going. So Josh Watkins is chasing Nick Bowers in the green 51. And behind him, the 13 car of Ryan Falconbridge. Across the line go Skritzker and Edwards, and you can see in the distance the orange cars, the Specialised Motorsport cars of Simon Horobin and Sam Preece. Horobin, who had a run of three retirements, two at Castle Coombe, one then in round 11 at Silverstone, which effectively dropped him out of the championship. Two you can stomach because there are two drop scores. Here is the view from Nathan Edwards, who seems to be getting into a race rhythm now. And Alfonso Skritzker, he's made a great amount of progress in this race. He's now under pressure from Edwards. JJ Ross is in behind, and that's Aaron Thompson's car. Missed it on the lap before. I saw a car parked up on the lap before, but that is Aaron Thompson out of third place. And sadly, another retirement of him as Nathan Edwards tries to squeeze down the inside, coming through clearways. Superb move by Nathan Edwards, side by side with Alfonso Skritzker. So Edwards is going to go through. JJ Ross is, I think, hedging his bets at the moment. JJ seems to like that wider line going into Paddock Hill Bend, even though there might be the opportunity to follow Edwards through. Here we are on board with Edwards again. The black car coming up the hill, the 21 machine. The youngster from Tunbridge Wells, graduate of the Fiesta Junior Championship. We've got so many of those now. And a very healthy year. It seems to go from strength to strength, the Junior Championship. And we've got another exciting finale, of course, in our sister programme for the Fiesta Juniors. And here is the onboard view along Cooper Strait, past the stricken car of Aaron Thompson. Aaron will be very disappointed to sit this out, the 41 car. That is, I think, a fourth retirement of the year. Across the line and onto the last lap here at Brands Hatch for the race leader, Simon Horobin. He's got the fastest lap as well, so it's going to be pole position point for him. Fastest lap point so far, and race lead very much clear of Sam Preece, who is edging towards the championship. Sam Preece in second place in the second of the orange cars. We can't see him back of shot because Simon Horobin wanted to make a statement by the look of it in this race, and he is well clear of any competition at all. Ryan Falconbridge facing the wrong way. A very scary position to be for Ryan Falconbridge at Paddock Hill Bend. They'll be very heavily waved yellows, but it's too late to put the safety car out for Ryan. I'm sure he'll get it going and rejoin the race and be a classified finisher as Simon Horobin comes through Clark Curvin onto the Brabham Straight to secure a win in round 15 of the BRSCC Quaife Fiesta Championship. There is the checker. Horobin takes the win from Sam Priest. Alfonso Skritzka is third from JJ Ross and Jamie Going. Miles Baker next from Nick Bowers, Josh Watkins, Lee Dendy Sadler and Nathan Edwards. Then Tim Glover, Richard Dawson, Jay Daniels, Dan Turner. Ryan Falconbridge recovers 15th from David Pugh, Dana Freeman and Jason Powell.
Well, the track is quite slippy. It's been green for the whole weekend, but qualifying didn't go to as planned. We qualified ninth, so obviously it's not the best of places to start, but luckily starting ninth, we fought our way through and finished third, so I was happy with that.
I'm very happy with that. It was very close at the beginning of the race. It spread out towards the end, and there were a bit of carnage behind me, and it just fell played into my hands, and I managed to get a second place and follow Simon home. Simon drove a great race, and I just followed his lines and cruised the car home in second place.
We have to keep the times in. That's what we do. We do a lot of development on just keeping them times and pace up. You know, I know I had to finish ahead of Sam. Just I can't beat Sam in the championship, but I can back him up from the second place. So I've got to go hell for leather.
Assembly for race one, the penultimate race of the season. Alistair Keller is set to win his third championship title out there sometime today, so we're going to try and catch up with him and catch his thoughts on the race and Jess King. And goodness me, we've got a melee of drivers here. Alistair, can I just jump in with you first? You've got a lot riding on this weekend. Your thoughts for the race is both the one we're about to go out for now.
Thoughts, hope to finish. Yeah, just need to finish first race, I think, anywhere. And that's it. Top out championships are done then, hopefully.
Alistair on pole position from John Cooper and Jamie White. Jess King on the outside of row two. Then Stuart Robbins and Class A pole man James Stiles from Adam Lynch and Jack Uhill. Tim Bennett next from Peter Dendy Sadler, Penny Jones and John Bateman. Simon Furlonger, 13th on the grid from Al Daly. Class B pole Luke Bannister from Theo Bridgman Williams, Christopher Horn and Kieran White completing the grid. Lights out and we are away. Kellett and Cooper off the grid, up front of the grid very quickly. So too is Tim Bennett. What a drive from Bennett. Third in class on the grid. He's up into fourth place overall. Mega start from Tim Bennett. Superb stuff from the blue Class A car. Really showing what they can do. We've got somebody off in the gravel at the back. I'm not sure that's going to get the safety car out. Bennett is still up there dicing at the moment with the man who is second in the Class D standings. That is Stuart Robbins in double zero. Here is the view from Bennett as the race leaders come along Cooper Straight for the first time, headed by the Irishman Alistair Keller. As you heard in the interviews, double bubble here potentially for him, but look at the scrap for second place. Jamie White in the light blue car chasing the Simply Car Sales machine of John Cooper, who is in second place. Cooper here could probably do without Jamie White in his mirrors because he wants to get a crack on and try and close down on Kellett and keep him honest through the race, if not get past as soon as he can as they cross the line. Just looking down towards Paddock Hill Bend, it looks like that errant car was cleared and we'll be back in the race as we go on board with Tim Bennett. What an absolutely magic start it was from Bennett, who is still there in fourth position. Very definitely that driver and car punching above their weight. Bennett coming under pressure though from Stuart Robbins in the double zero. Robbins in the Indigo car, and behind Stuart we've got Jess King, who runs fourth in the championship. Just to let you know on championship points, as again Jamie White looks up the inside line into Surtees. Here's the view from Cooper. Keep your eyes to the left. There's a little flash of light blue which tells us that White is there. Tim Bennett runs wide. Through on the inside line goes Stuart Robbins in the Indigo car. I think Jess King will try and follow through. Bennett not in danger at the moment of losing the class lead and driving a very good race indeed. And he's on the outside line. Jess King is going to try and pass him on the inside now. The run down towards Paddock Hill Bend, and Jess goes through. Tim Bennett still maintaining class lead and a fair way clear of the nearest rivals. Remember, I said it was James Stiles who started on pole position in Class A from Adam Lynch. Tim Bennett was third. Peter Dendy-Sadler was fourth in qualifying in Class A. In Class A for the mid-1990s Mark III Fiesta SIs, running an 1800cc engine. And that's the great thing about this championship. We've got four classes. They've all been supported well this year. So if you're looking and thinking about coming saloon car racing, this is an ideal championship to start, because there's very definitely superb choice and effectively a ladder where you can come in, race perhaps one of the older cars with a little bit less pressure on the older cars, the Class A and Bs, which started the championship all those years ago. Class A starting back in 1997 when Mike Gorton won the championship in its first year as an independent championship after being a toker package championship. But through on the inside line goes Jamie White. So White has got second position and will take up the challenge now. But coming back at him on the inside line superbly goes John Cooper. Oh, what a wonderful piece of racing by the two. White goes on the grass. Here's the view from Cooper back into second position. They've almost got the racing line mapped out there, although it's a little bit wide for Cooper. Oh, hands off the gear stick there for him. It's a fraught race between the two. Stuart Robbins, remember, second in the championship, is running fourth position in this race. He's going to talk about the other classes involved. We've already seen the Class C cars, the STs, in their own separate races. The Class B cars here run the smaller 1400cc Z-Tech, the Mark V Fiesta. And of course, the lead cars that we're watching now, the latest class, Class D, the Z-Tech S three-door 1600cc. So if you're thinking about coming racing, talk to any of the teams, have a look at the website. If you Google BRSCC Fiestas, you'll find out a lot more about this championship. There are hire cars available for you to have the chance to come and have a race or a test with one of the teams to see if you fancy coming in and racing this superb championship. John Cooper is driving well. He's in second. Jamie White still there in third. Stuart Robbins is in fourth. Alistair Kellett starting to work his way through some of the backmarker traffic. 18 cars in classes A, B and D this weekend. 20 in Class C. We have at times on the larger circuits, of course, merged all four classes. But this weekend, one of those regular occasions where we have to split the grids and have separate races for the different classes, and Class C having separate race because they're the best subscribed still with 20 cars. Here is the view from John Cooper, and you can see Alistair Kellett, that's who he's focused on, going over the brow and down into Paddock Hill, still the race leader. And Cooper is getting a little bit of a crack on here, but he's getting clear now. You can see second and third getting ahead of the fourth place car, or maybe they're not, because Cooper's still under pressure from Jamie White in the 46 car, who momentarily had second position. And really, these two could perhaps do well to work with each other. They won't want to do that, though. They're just fighting it out for second position on the road along Cooper Strait. Here is John Cooper, and half of the length of that straight is the lead at the moment for Alistair Kellett, who's picking off the back markers. And what a finish to the season it would be for Kellett if he can take a race win to secure the championship. No better way of securing, of course, not just one title but two, because he's looking to be overall champion. And in doing so, he will emulate Ed Cockhill, who won the overall championship and the Class D title back in 2014 when we saw David Elsley win the Class C honours. Keith Chapman was Class B champion that year. Ian Scruton completing a double in Class A. Last year's Class A champion was James Stiles, as past Christopher Horn, who's leading Class B here. So no slouch either. We saw a flash on the lights. Chris Horn doing a super job at the moment, 15th on the road, and leading Luke Bannister and Kieran White. Luke Bannister, the Class B champion this year, wrapped it up on Anglesey. So Cooper running well and actually closing in now on Alistair Kellett. Cooper's got the fastest lap of the race on lap 16 and is starting to close in on the race leader. Kellett is running well, still dealing with backmarker traffic, and here we go on board with the man who leads the Class D standings and indeed the overall BRSCC Quaife Fiesta Championship standings. But if he looks in his mirrors, he will see that John Cooper has closed him down. This is the battle though for Class A. Tim Bennett, who had a huge lead in the early stages after that mega start, is coming under pressure from Adam Lynch. And Lynch is going to have a look at the inside line. Bennett's going to come across. You can see how much of a lead they've got over the other cars in Class A. Just looking to the left of shot to see whether we're going to see Lynch go past. Now remember, Lynch was second in qualifying behind James Stiles. Everybody incidentally still running in this race, which is superb testament to driving standards and race preparation as Alistair Kellett continues to work his way through the field. So Kellett across the line, John Cooper still in second. Cooper would love to deprive this man of a win. Kellett, to be fair to him, doesn't even have to win this race to secure both titles. So he is an absolute racer, though. Many others, having won the championship, would maybe just think, OK, top three, that'll do. Get a step on the podium. But Kellett very clearly wants to take the race win here. And John Cooper has battled hard, getting away from Jamie White. There is White, the light blue car, around about 10 lengths or so behind Cooper at the moment, but still on for another podium position. Jamie White, who surprisingly has only had one win so far this year, class win at Castle Coombe in race number two. And here is John Cooper, who is piling the pressure on. Cooper has had a fair number of second places, been a regular on the podium, and chases Kellett across the line once again. Looks like they might get a clear lap here. Kellett took pole position today by 0.07 of a second from Cooper. Cooper at the moment with fastest lap, a 57.201, averaging just under 80 miles an hour. Kellett not too far behind, best lap for him, a 57.3, and still there in the lead down through Graham Hill Bend for the last time they go, and along Cooper Strait. And this is the view from Kellett. He's got a clear run at the moment going up into Surtees and then round into McLaren. There was pressure. I don't think the pressure is as much now on this final lap. Here they come then, through, out of clear ways. Clark Curve onto the Brabham straight. Alistair Kellett is going to sew up the championship with a win. His hands are on the lights to flash. There's the checker. Kellett is a double champion, the Class D champion. Our congratulations to him. John Cooper waves in acknowledgement as well. Kellett from Cooper and Jamie White. Stuart Robbins next from Jess King. And Jack Yuho. Adam Lynch wins Class A from Tim Bennett. Then James Stiles. John Bateman is next from Peter Dendy, Sadler and Penny Jones. Al Daly next from Theo Bridgman-Williams. Christopher Hall wins Class B. Luke Bannister next from Simon Furlonger and Kieran White.
2016 overall and class championship, I think. So very good. Great race, very slippery to start, and John and Jamie were all over me, and then Jamie and John started battling, got away a little bit, caught back markers, and just controlled it to the end. I just had to finish, and that was it. Very hard to do.
I just couldn't quite get past him. I did get past him. He made a mistake coming into clearways, but I just couldn't hold it. I got him into paddock, and then he could just do a late lunge down the inside up at Drury, so made a bit of little coming together, but nothing minor. Just couldn't then get it back.
I don't know what to say. It was just like, oh no, not now. But I just managed to get back past in front of him. I think he got caught in traffic after that. And just managed to drag back up to Alistair.
Welcome back to Brands Hatch. And it is Simon Horribin on pole position from Sam Priest, Nathan Edwards and JJ Ross next from Ryan Falkenbridge and Aaron Thompson, then Nick Bowers and Miles Baker, Alfonso Skritzker and Jamie Going next up from Josh Watkins and Dan Turner. Tim Glover and Lee Dendy Sadler on row 7 from Richard Dawson and Jay Daniels. The ninth row, David Pugh and Dana Freeman. The grid completed by Jason Powell and Kevin Gooding. We are underway. A very quick start indeed. And Sam Priest is being squeezed. Nathan Edwards looks up the inside. JJ Ross around the outside. And on the outside of him, it's Aaron Thompson challenging for third place. Thompson challenging for third. Big sideways moment for Dan Turner in the third orange specialised car there on the outside line of Josh Watkins in red. But the race leaders are up to Druids already. Thompson still negotiating the outside line and trying to hope that converts the inside at Graham Hill Bend as we drop back to Josh Watkins and the 17 car of Dan Turner. Watkins here might be able to squeeze round on the outside lap, and Aaron Thompson is in third now ahead of JJ Ross. Then it's Nathan Edwards side by side with Miles Baker, Alfonso Skritzker followed by Jamie Going. Nick Bowers is there as well. Skritzker on the inside line, the white car with the green wheels on the inside of Miles Baker in car number 99. You might remember watching Miles taking his way, making his way to on the tarmac to a third place at Anglesey last time out, round 14. This, though, is the 16th race of the season, as out of the race very early on, lap number one, Richard Dawson needs some Marshall muscle to get him back on circuit. Meanwhile, the Packer already up at Druids, with Aaron Thompson now ahead of the championship leader, Sam Preece. So Thompson goes through. Here's Nathan Edwards looking at the rear end of JJ Ross. Ross running in fourth place at the moment behind Sam Preece. And all eyes need to be on Alfonso Skritzker. There he is, the white car with the green wheels, running at the moment in sixth place and trying to close down on Nathan Edwards. He needs to get ahead of, he needs to basically outscore Sam Preece by 10 points in this race. In fact, 11 points, because he hasn't won a race this year. The gap was 9 points on drop scores coming into this meeting, and Sam Preece outscored Alfonso by a solitary point in race number one. So that means that the gap on drop scores is out to 10 points. It is confusing on drop scores, but we'll try and keep you abreast in these programmes of how that does pan out. It's a perfectly fair thing to do, I guess, at this level. A little bit harsh perhaps on Alfonso Skritzker, who hasn't had a retirement all year. He's been so consistent, an extremely well-prepared car and well-driven car as well. He's dropping back, Skritzker. Big gap now between Edwards, the back of the leading five cars you can see coming along the straight, and very definitely Skritzker is further behind than he was on the last lap. Skritzker coming under pressure from Miles Baker, who goes through on the inside. Now Alfonso not looking happy at the moment. Jamie Going and Nick Bowers are behind, so Going is going to nip through, I think, on the inside line as well. No, it's the outside line. Skritzker has a problem on the rear end there, a little wobble, and he's into pit lane. And that's the curse of the commentator, because I said he hadn't had a retirement all year. Mind you, it's not a retirement yet, but he is in pit lane. So Skritzker, that is going to be provisionally championship over for Alfonso Skritzker. And the man in third place, who we're not seeing at the moment because we've got some terrific battling going on in the lower reaches of the top 10. Ryan Falconbridge looking around the outside line there. And Ryan on the inside of Lee Dendy Sadler in the silver grey 11. But meanwhile, out front, it's still Simon Horobin. Aaron Thompson there in the white and red car is in second place, followed by champion-elect, perhaps, Sam Preece. Commentated on Preece in karting, so another of the very quick karters that's moved up into saloon car racing. JJ Ross is there as well. Edwards closes up big time under braking into Druids. Now downhill, down Graham Hill, into Graham Hill Bend. Meanwhile, back and coming up the hill, we have Lee Dendy Sadler in the mix. Josh Watkins is there as well. This is Josh Watkins coming down Graham Hill in towards Graham Hill Bend. Perennially the point where we get told off about track limits, but nobody causing any problems, I think, at this meeting. And looks like we could have a pass on in front. So Watkins goes through Surtees up into McLaren now. Sometimes you can have a dive down the inside because there's a gap, and he's had he's been rear-ended. And it's the 31 car of Jay Daniels. Now, what we didn't see was the build-up to that. All we saw and perhaps felt a little bit was the rear-ending of that car. JJ Ross's dad watching, Bob watching, I think that was, from the inner paddock, the Grand Prix paddock, as it used to be known. It means we've got the safety car out here for the recovery of Josh Watkins' car, who becomes the third retirement of the race, following Richard Dawson on lap number one. Championship contender Alfonso Skritzker also out of the race, and Josh Watkins now. So two of the biggest names in the championship are out, but the lights are out now on the safety car. We're getting ready for the restart with Simon Horobin still leading from Aaron Thompson. Horobin knows what to do in this situation, a very experienced and fast driver. You can see the recovery still going on, but the race organisers rightly wanting to get underway as soon as is practicably possible. So here they come off Clark Curve. Aaron Thompson has driven a very good restart here, and he's keeping Horobin close. Simon Horobin hasn't managed to get away from Aaron Thompson, so Horobin not under a huge amount of pressure, and in fact now Thompson is as well, from Sam Priest in third position. JJ Ross in fourth, Nathan Edwards is in behind, so restart is played out pretty sensibly. Jamie going down there behind Miles Baker. Here's the view from Nathan Edwards again. Edwards will be keen to try and finish off the season with a podium at the very least. JJ Ross is going to be a difficult man to beat though. Remember, Ross won last year's championship from Scott Robertson, with Simon Horobin in third place. Sam Priest was fourth from Jamie Going. And there is Nathan Edwards chasing hard. And of course, the established drivers always effectively have to look over their shoulders each year now for graduates from the junior championship making the step up into senior formulae, which they can do. It is essentially the junior championship, a three-year program, but you can move out of the juniors at the age of 16 into senior formulae, and therefore maybe miss the third year if you have two good years, 14 and 15. But here are the race leaders. Horobin again starting to have to try and build up a little bit of a lead over Aaron Thompson, who's not being left at the moment. Nick Bowers is busy chasing Dan Turner, who's looking pretty handy in that third orange Specialized Motorsport car. A little bit of a gap between himself and Jamie Going. Here they go along Cooper Strait, and Horobin looking for another win. There is Aaron Thompson still chasing Simon Horobin, keeping him honest at the moment. Horobin still with fastest lap set back on lap four of what should be a 20 lap race. Race timed out at 20 minutes. So we're looking at fourth place car, the 21 machine of Nathan Edwards, race winner at Castle Coombe. We've had a lot of different race winners this year. JJ Ross, I won't say JJ's been race rusty, but he has done selected rounds this year. It'd be great to see perhaps him back next year and do a full championship tilt against Sam Priest if we see Sam back, if Sam isn't tempted to move further up the motorsport ladder. But we'll have to see who comes back next year, because across the line we go again. Priest is there in third place. Edwards is in fourth from JJ Ross. Then Miles Baker from Jamie Going in seventh place. Dan Turner in the orange car at the back of shot is running in eighth. Then Nick Bowers in his standout green machine, as Baker starts to put the pressure on JJ Ross for fifth place. He's got his nose up the inside, but Ross knows the inside line for Graham Hill. Bend is crucial, but Baker's going to try and hold on the outside, or maybe go for the cut back on the inside to Surtees. Doesn't seem to have the momentum along the straight, and it's still Simon Horobin. Pole position again, fastest lap again. Looks like it could be lights out to flag for Simon Horobin in this one. He's been kept very honest indeed by Aaron Thompson in second position, who split the two Specialized Motorsport boys. And I think the Jam Sport team are going to be pleased with that. But here is Simon Horobin, who goes across the line and onto his last lap here at Brands Hatch, the last lap of the 2016 BRSCC Quaife Fiesta Championship for Class C. And Horobin has driven absolutely superbly here. Thompson has continued to give chase, and the gap around about a second between Horobin and Thompson. The older of the two drivers is the man in front, Thompson, the youngster from Romford, who really can underline a good debut year in senior motorsport here. And if he looks back at the championship positions for last year, know that the man in front of him was third last year. This year's champion was fourth. So Aaron Thompson knows that a second year, which is all important in this sort of racing, particularly at senior level, could well carry him further up the grid. But coming down onto the Clark Curve and onto Brabham Straight for the last time to see the chequered flag, to make it a double here at Brands Hatch. A perfect weekend for Simon Horobin. It's a perfect weekend for the team. Provisionally, they are champions. Thompson second, Priest third from Nathan Edwards, JJ Ross, Miles Baker in sixth place from Jamie Going and Dan Turner. Nick Bowers takes ninth position. Ryan Falconbridge completing the top 10. Simon Horobin, confirmation of his fastest lap as well. 11th was Tim Glover from Lee Dendy Sadler and Jay Daniels. David Punex from Dana Freeman, then Jason Powell and Kevin Gooding. Yeah!
a great championship, and we possibly won with that, so we're ecstatic. Specialised Motorsport put a great car out there for me all year. We've been at the front of the grid, it's proven this weekend, and thanks to my sponsors, HSA Tech, Ken Mallinson's, Mintex, my mum and dad, JRA Vehicles, everyone out there has put me a great car, and I can't thank them enough.
Aaron, what a cracking race to finish the season on. How would you sum up your season?
Great. I mean, there's been so much hard work put in. I just got to thank my dad, Jamsport, everyone here, SCT Contracts, make this all possible. I mean, it just showed then, when everything's fair, clean and great, how close this racing can be. I mean, it's the hardest I've ever drove, and yeah, it wasn't a win, but I'm proud of myself, I'm proud of my team.
We had a couple of wins at Anglesey, and obviously we've come here and done the same again. So, all looks good.
Last race of the day, last race of the season. Alistair Kellett secured the wins last time out. Luke Bannister secured Class B at the last meeting. I'm just going to catch a quick word with him before he goes out. Last race of the season. Congratulations on class win.
Thank you.
What are you going to get out there today? Last race.
Bit of enjoyment. I'm trying my best. Home circuit. Just nice pressures off. Going to have a bit of fun.
Luke is 16th on the grid, second in Class B. The overall grid headed by Alistair Kellett from John Cooper and Jamie White. Stuart Robbins next from Jess King, then Jack Uhill and Adam Lynch. Tim Bennett in 8th from James Stiles and John Bateman. Then Peter Dendy Sadler, Penny Jones and Al Daly. Theo Bridgman-Williams, Chris Horn on pole position for Class B from Luke Bannister. Then Simon Furlonger and Kieran White completing the 18-car group, which is underway now. And a good start from the front row from Kellett and Cooper. Once again, super start again from Tim Bennett on the outside line, really getting stuck in, and in, I think, fourth position or possibly fifth, coming down Paddock Hill Bend as they go up Halewood Hill for the first time. It's a good start by all concerned. Kieran White is off the line. He is in 18th place at the moment. Bennett is in fifth position. Up into third place goes Stuart Robbins. Here is the view from Penny Jones, Fast Lady Racer, a renowned mini racer, Penny Jones, and making the switch over from mini to Z-Tech S Fiesta racing and learning her craft. And this could well be a lady to watch next year in this championship. But we're looking at the battle for third place at the moment, which is held by Stuart Robbins. Flash of the top two going through. Jamie White finds himself down in fourth place. Then we've got Tim Bennett in fifth ahead of Jack Uhill. Bennett, how quick at starting is he? Could probably, if he could can that, he could sell that technique, couldn't he? There's a lot of drivers I know that would be very pleased indeed to have that skill in starting. As we look at James Stiles, looking at the inside line there on John Bateman up the hill, and up into third position goes Jamie White, the Essex-based racer, going through on the inside line and demoting the Shaftesbury-based driver, Stuart Robbins, down into fourth place. As we go back and pick up on John Bateman, about to be challenged by the 127 of James Stiles. Bateman running in Class A. So here they come along Cooper Strait. Jack Uhill in front of them. And in fourth position is Adam Lynch, I think, the man who won the Class A in race number one. Through on the inside line goes James Stiles. Bateman running a little bit wide. So Stiles is through. So second, third and fourth in Class A are all very close together indeed. Christopher Horn leading Class B once again and looking to try and make it a double this weekend, as Adam Lynch goes to the outside line on John Bateman into Paddock Hill Bend. Thinks better of it. He's going to go for the cut back on the inside instead. Bateman leaves the door open, so it's a run up towards Druids and he goes through. So there is Jack Uhill, and back into third place in class then goes Adam Lynch. We've still got Tim Bennett, I think, out front in class at the moment from James Stiles in second position now in the 127 car. There is Alistair Kellett still in second place. Jamie White closing in on Kellett. But what a start from John Cooper. Cooper looking for his first win of the season. Cooper's had, I think, three retirements, one non-start so far this season. The man from Ossett been a regular on the podium, as we said, in race number one. Tim Bennett now is down behind Lynch. So we've got the 127 car of James Stiles. You can see the blue and orange car ahead of Jack Uhill is class leader. Adam Lynch we're looking at immediately in front. His second position in class A. And Jack Uhill running in, I think, sixth position at the moment in class D, the number 93. Jack's been a great addition to the championship, having had several fourth positions in the championship this year. So he's been a consistent point scorer. So James Stiles is now the class leader and has Uhill between himself and the 127, the 60 car of Adam Lynch, who's running in second now. But Lynch is closing up, as you can see, on Jack Uhill, with Tim Bennett in third place. Jessica King goes through shot in fifth position. So it is still Stiles that holds on to the class lead. Jack Uhill getting in between them at the moment. So a little bit of breathing space here for the leading class A driver, who goes wide. But here is John Cooper, fastest lap in race number one. And he was only a shade slower, as we said, in race number one in terms of qualifying pace. So he knew he was there or thereabouts with this year's outright champion and class D champion Alistair Kellett, who succeeds David Nye as champion in the Formula Ed Cockhill, as we said, winning it in 2014. David Abbott, the inaugural champion in class D back in 2013. And here is the view from Alistair Kellett, who is one of the longest travelling drivers in British motorsport, coming over from Kells in Ireland to race in this championship. And what a year he has had. He's piling the pressure on John Cooper at the moment. So good to see the battle for the outright lead of a race at this stage of the season, particularly when Alistair Kellett doesn't need to do this. He's got the championship sewn up. So it's about the passion of racing here for Alistair Kellett, and indeed for John Cooper, who wants the win. There is Cooper, the 88 car, showing a clean pair of heels at the moment to Kellett, who's chasing him. A little bit of a gap back to third position. Jamie White is still running in third place ahead of Stuart Robbins. And they head along the main straight and cross the line and tick off another lap. Although these races are not a number of laps, they're timed races, the BRSCC races. 20 minutes of track time is allocated for the race, which will include safety car. And it was 21 laps that we had, of course, without incident in race number one. So we could maybe expect the same here in race number two, as Kellett is starting to put in a little bit of a charge here, a little bit of attack. He's getting closer. And of course, he's got to try and work out where he can go past, unless the race leader makes a mistake. The first car that they go into, that's going to be Kieran White, who is 18th on the grid. So Kieran leaves room, goes to the outside of the track. Difficult for a back marker there, because you've got Surtees going off to the left, and then you've got the long right-handers. But White left enough room on the inside line for the race leaders to go through. So we pick up on Theo Bridgman-Williams, who is there with Christopher Thorne. Theo running in Class A. Christopher Thorne, who's done a grand job this weekend in Class B, qualified second in class behind Luke Bannister. And as you can see, has got Luke Bannister right with him at the moment, this year's Class B champion. So be great to tempt Christopher Hall back, hopefully, to race next year and do a full championship campaign. There is still competition, of course, in classes A and B, as well as the D class here. And the competition at the moment for the race lead is with Alistair Kellett, who, look at the wide line into Druids, very definitely notice of intent from this year's BRSCC Quaife Fiesta champion, who's all over the back of John Cooper. And it's role reversal here from race number one, because Kellett won the race and the two titles in race one, but Cooper had the fastest lap. And it's Kellett who is the man with the pace here on lap 13, a fastest lap of 57.27. It's not quite as quick as the fastest lap of Cooper in race number one, but Kellett knows that he's got the pace here, and he's trying to latch himself onto the rear end of the race leader and maybe harry him into a little mistake. Maybe he'll run wide and Kellett might be able to go through on the inside line as they cross the line here again. Kellett is challenging nothing to defend from for Alistair Kellett, so he can pretty much do what he likes. And maybe have a look at the inside line. He's keeping it slightly tighter up Halewood's Hill, goes back to the outside line and will chase. It could depend this race on how the back markers fall for these two drivers. No problems as they come past that back marker down into Graham Hill Bend. And it is still Cooper out front, but Kellett is harrying him all the way. This is a good race between these two. Very, very evenly matched. So Cooper, to some extent, will be looking in his mirrors. He's defensive here, rightly so, coming through McLaren and Clearways and holding on to it. Didn't want to leave that gap down the inside going through Clearways, which the Formula Fords will do. The checkered flag is at the ready, though, and it's going to be Cooper to take his first win of the year. John Cooper takes the win. Alistair Kellett in second position from Jamie White and Stuart Robbins. Jessica King fifth from Adam Lynch, who wins Class A. Jack Uhl next from James Stiles and Tim Bennett. Penny Jones 10th from Peter Dendy Sadler and Al Daly. Simon Furlonger, head of Class B winner Chris Horn. Then Luke Bannister, Theo Bridgman Williams and Kieran White 17th.
The first one I won this year, and it was hard work, very hard work.
Did you enjoy it though?
I did. I just got a good start, and it were reasonably easy to defend in places. Backmarkers helped me a little bit, and I don't think Alistair pushed too hard because he's won anyway. So
it didn't really matter where I finished, and John got to jump me at the start, and we had the best race of the whole year. We didn't judge, it was really clean, and he was struggling towards the end, and it was just brilliant fun.
The car wasn't there today. We'll have to take it away, work on it over the winter season. Hopefully, first race next year, we'll be back on the top step.
Great, that answers my next question. So you plan to be back out in 2017 then?
We plan to be back out in 2017, yeah. We'll just see how the winter goes.
Overall and class championship, I think.